these tanks. What's this about? Can't pass through without one of those chips. Gotta be one around here somewhere.
Always lost, unknown. Okay. Integration irregularities. We have begun to observe a new and unexpected side effect of stem integration in certain Union citizens. The symptoms begin simply enough. Small mental breakdowns triggered by vestigial memory overlaps. Affected citizens begin to experience their old memories, which leaves them in a state of confusion. Rewriting their memories again is only a stopgap measure. Their new Union designations serve only to confuse them further. Soon, these small breaks develop into complete disassociation and eventually total physical metamorphosis. This phenomenon is currently affecting only 0.005% of the populace, but it's troubling nonetheless. Much was learned before the Beacon incident, but STEM is still experiencing experimental technology. We are isolating our studies while we continue to expand Union. It is imperative that we stop this before it escalates. There. No. That's fine. Hi, stairs. I don't know how to get in there, though. Gunpowder. Ooh, I want that. Please. Regularity studies. The phenomenon has become more prevalent. We have dedicated the entire laboratory wing of the Marrow to studying it. Citizens' transformations have become quick, violent, and even more obscene. They are mutated into forms that can't even be considered humanoid. They have lost their semblance of humanity altogether. We have dubbed these, the affected citizens, the Lost. We have determined that the last phase before metamorphosis involves the belief that they are being pursued by some invisible but inescapable force. Once they have succumbed to this force, their transformation begins. STEM is an artificial construct. There are no viruses, bacteria, or contagion here. The Lost phenomenon is therefore a mental process. We are still in the dark as to how it spreads and to whom it will spread next. Perhaps the trigger is present in the subjects before they have entered STEM. Further research is needed. Ooh, 30 out of 40. Nice. Somewhere. This one.
What do we have here?
Operative case. Our worst fears have been realized. The lost phenomenon has spread to Mobius operatives. We had theorized that transformations were a result of memory override, but no operatives have been overwritten. We were able to quarantine and terminate an effective Mobius operative before he could transform. Perhaps his exposure to so many lost corpses in the pit made him susceptible to whatever is causing it. Perhaps it is merely a coincidence. We are harvesting his Unity cerebral chip in hopes that it will provide new data. Removal of the intact cerebral chip is possible with the extraction device. It's a relatively simple and automated process. Merely place the subject on the gurney and enter the extraction device's activation code 0128.
If they haven't removed this guy's chip yet, I can use it to get through that door and find Hoffman.
Oh crap, it was code 1. That's not right. What was it? Oh. 01.
Okay, let's see what happens.
Gross. I don't know anybody would ever want to do this. Wouldn't that like break the chip though? Okay. This electronic chip was implanted in the brain of a Mobius operative.
Oh, thank God he's already dead. I gotta get out of this lab.
Oh crap. Yeah, I know there's another thing in here. Hang on. Awesome. I know. Chill out for a second.
Of Union's populace have succumbed already.
Our efforts have been in vain. The Corps escaped less than a day ago. Within hours, we began to receive reports of lost emerging in staggering numbers. They're everywhere now. 20% of Union's populace have succumbed already.
Oh boy.
And they're actively hunting down and killing whoever is left. It's a nightmare. At this rate, there will be no one left in 2 weeks. We've lost contact with Mobius. We're trapped in here. Lost. It's too late to stop now. The entire Union experiment is doomed. We're all doomed. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's harsh. Where's that one? Oh, there was one up here. Didn't realize that. Oh, hey. Oh, that one really went down quick with the silence going. Any more in here or not, but
these Union citizens? What was Mobius doing with them?
Oh boy.
Looks like it goes down forever.
Yeah. lonely in here and creepy, dumping these bodies, these things, into the pit. And they just keep coming. How did I end up with this detail? Been hearing things, voices, coming from the pit. That can't be. But if they aren't coming from the pit, then they're in my head, and that's even worse. Aureole hallucination is one of the symptoms, but I can't be affected. It's not a virus or bacteria, it's a mental thing that only infects citizens whose memories have been rewritten. At least, that's what they've told me. Shit, I've got to keep it together. It's just loneliness that's making me think like this. Loneliness and being around these freaky corpses. It's not the phenomenon.
Oh no. It's coming. I gotta get out of here.
Go anywhere.
Thank you.
that's a problem.
To do in this place.
I don't care, just freaking run. What's this? Letter from Police Chief, November 17, 2014. Jim here, just a quick note to give you an update on the Castellanos beacon situation. sending Sebastian in for mandatory counseling. The Beacon incident needs to be kept under wraps, and the good detective is our only loose end. We have many operatives in KCPD, but not enough to ensure total information blackout. Fortunately, our staff psychologist is on the organization's payroll. Once we determine how much Castellanos knows, we can easily instill self-doubt through these sessions. When we're through with him, Sebastian won't be sure if he witnessed a Beacon was real. Not that he needs much help. He's been stumbling through his assignments like a zombie. Poor son of a bitch is obviously having trouble dealing with whatever happened to him in there. I almost feel bad for him. I've known the guy for over a decade. It's like he's a different person now. But that's the price of progress. If you want to make an omelet, you gotta break an egg or two. James Van Kirk, KCPD.